Myself, Pungita Tiwari, from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology, from IT Asset Department. I'm going to take a session from the subject that is computer vision. The subject code is 3171614. The module that we are going to cover is module number 3, that is feature detection. The topic that we are going to cover, that is corner detection, line and curve detection with further algorithms. So in the last lecture, we have seen about the Herve transforms. Now with respect to that, initially the same thing that we have continued with. So we'll be seeing what we have done. So we are already seeing images and pixels, edges, lines, objects and scenes. So right now we are at the lines part. So basically we are doing the lines detection scenes and line algorithms. So basically we have already seen the Herve transform, the various properties, okay, how it has been done, the algorithm, the form, okay. So with respect to that, we also have Rensec based line detection algorithm, okay, with respect to Herve transform. So another alternative to the Herve transform is the random sample consensus, that is the Rensec algorithm, which is described in more detail in the other sections as well. Okay, but right now we will be learning also how it has been working. So in brief, the Rensec, we can say, randomly chooses the pairs of edges to form a line hypothesis. Whenever the word hypothesis come, it has been arised with respect to the assumptions that we are doing it in order to test what, how many other edges will fall on this line that we are taking it. So if the edge orientations are accurate enough, a single edge can produce this hypothesis. So the lines with significantly, we can say sufficiently large numbers of inliners, okay, that is matching edges, are then selected as a desired line segment. Okay, so with respect to that, we need to keep in mind whenever an advantage comes, I mean, what will be the advantage which has been given to us with respect to the Rensec based algorithm. So an advantage of Rensec is that no accumulator array is needed. We will be needing it, the accumulator array, in the Herve transform, but here it is no need. And so the algorithm can be more space efficient, you can say, and potentially less prone to the choice of bin size, because here we are not removing the content of previous one, because there is no accumulator array. Whenever it comes with the array part, whenever it comes with the data part, whenever it comes to the updation part, we need to update it, and we have to remove the memory size, we have to keep in record, we have to store in another of the array. So these are the things that we need to keep in mind whenever a line detection or whenever an array is being passed. But here there is no array, so this is the profit. The disadvantage is that many more hypotheses may need to be generated, okay, because hypothesis is what? Assumptions. And assumption is what? Whenever you want to make an assumption, you need to keep in mind many of the things, and you have to assume more, and which is mean, we can say, tested, and those obtained by finding the peaks in the accumulator array. So in general, there is no clear consensus on which the line estimation techniques performs the best. So it is therefore a good idea to think carefully about the problem at hand and to implement several approaches, okay, to determine the one that works best for your application. Okay, so the next point that we are going to be discussing about the line is the vanishing points. Okay, whenever a line is being recorded, whenever it is being taken place in the form of projections, there is a vanishing point. Whenever we talk about the prospective projections, there is a vanishing point. We have one vanishing point, two vanishing point, and three vanishing points. So with respect to that, how many scenes, that is structurally we can say important lines, having the same vanishing point because they are parallel in 3D. Okay, so with respect to that, we can say examples of such lines that I am talking about are horizontal, vertical also, with respect to building edges, then we can say zebra crossings that we have, okay, then we are having railway tracks, and also the edges of the furniture such as tables, okay, dresses, we can say, of course, the ubiquitous, that is calibration pattern that we have. Okay, so these all the things will have a particular vanishing point that we are taking it whenever the projections are taken parallelly in a 3D form or a 2D form. So finding the vanishing points common to such line sets which are already there can help refine their position in the image. Also in certain cases, it will help to determine the intrinsic and the extrinsic orientation of the cameras as well. So these are the many points that we need to keep in mind whenever we are talking about the vanishing points of a particular line. Okay, so here we can say the real world vanishing points will include many of the things like architecture, then different forms of furniture that we have, okay, calibration patterns that we have, and that will be looking in the formula, in the form of like architecture, like building blocks that we can see. The vanishing point that we can find it out means taking of projections at a particular point where the image will vanish, okay. Then we have like furniture that we have, okay. Then we have the third point is in calibration patterns that we have, the wherever we are using it in our any of the field that we are having it. So these are the different forms, that is where vanishing points can be described with respect to the different parameters. Okay, so here the vanishing points, we can say the first stage in the vanishing point detection algorithm uses a Yoke transform, Hopf transform that we already seen, to accumulate votes for what likely that is vanishing point candidates. So whenever we talk about the vanishing points, it always using the it is using the Yoke transform where the voting for likely that is vanishing point candidates is being formed to accumulate it. So as with the line fitting, we can say one possible approach is what is to have each line vote for all the possible vanishing point directions either using a cube map or a Gaussian sphere. Optionally, we can say using knowledge about the uncertainty in the vanishing point location to perform a weighted vote. Okay, so this is what I have talked about the vanishing point. So my preferred approach where I can use or you can use is to use pairs of detected line segments to form candidate that is vanishing point locations. Okay, this is what the approach is that we can take for a particular vanishing point detection. So suppose we are supposing it for that, let M of I, that is M is a, we can say unit normal vector, M of I and M of J, real and imaginary part, be the unit form, that is line equations for a pair of line segment that we have, and the L of I and L of J be their corresponding line lengths. So the location of the corresponding vanishing point, that is hypothesis, can be computed where Bij is equals to Mij into M cross M of J. So Bij will be equal to M of I and M of J, but the corresponding weight set to define for a particular weight set, that is V of Ij is equals to W of Ij, means weight of Ij is equal to V of Ij, that is modulus, double modulus with respect to I of I and L of I and L of J. So L of I and L of J with respect to the line segment that we are taking for the real and imaginary part. So this has been a desirable effect for down weighting, that is linear, that is collinear line segment that we have, and the short line segment that we are taking into consideration whenever we are taking a line in a particular XY axis. So with respect to that, we can say the Hopf that already been space, which the Hopf space that is already been itself, can either be represented using spherical coordinates or we can say cube map. Okay, so the cube map representation for a line segment equations and the vanishing points, we can say here the cube map has been shown here. Okay, the cube is being taken with respect to the vanishing points, with respect to the two or four of the sides, okay, which is being taken from this side to that side. So here four of the forms is being taken. Here the three of the subspace is being created, at subspace 1, subspace 2 and subspace 3 with respect to B width, B by 2 width and A by B width. Okay, so these are the three of the forms with respect to the subspaces that we have, half cube into the three of the spaces. So dividing the of the whole, or we can say the half of the cube into three of the sides, the three of the subspaces that we have and that we have been shown here. Okay, so these are the things that we need to keep in mind whenever the vanishing points is being taken. So once the group, that is accumulator space, has been populated, okay, so peaks can be detected where in a similar manner to that previously discussed for the line detection that we have already discussed. Okay, whenever we are discussing the line segments, we are always having a set of candidate, that is line segments that we have been voted for a vanishing point, so which can be optionally be kept as a list at each Hopf accumulator set that we are going to update it. So I then use a robust least squares fit to estimate a more accurate locations for each vanishing point. Here I is the scientist itself that have been derived for the vanishing point. So which is been using a robust least squares fit to estimate a more accurate location. Okay, considering the relationship between the two of the line segments, endpoint that is P of I0 and P of I1 and the vanishing point B as shown in the figure that we have seen, the area triangle A of the triangle given by the three of the points, which is the magnitude of the product form, which is equals to A of I is equals to P of I0 cross E of I1 into B, that is the vector product. So with respect to that, we can say that it is proportional to the perpendicular distance D1, which is already there between the two of the endpoints, or we can say the each of the endpoint, and the line through which V and the other endpoint as well as the distance between the PRI of 0 and the V will be there. Okay, so assuming that the accuracy of a fitted line segment, we can say, is proportional to its endpoint, we can say accuracy, this therefore serves as an optimal metric for how well a vanishing point fits a set of extracted lines. Okay, so these are the things with respect to keep in mind whenever we are talking about the vanishing point. So a robustified least squares, okay, will estimate for a vanishing point can therefore be written as, we can say, that is E. We can say E in the form of null, like this being visible like that, which is given to summation of I with respect to all the values, where P of A of I, it's a function which we are applying it for a vanishing point, is equal to V of T. Okay, V of T means the transpose value, which has been taken in the form of equation sigma of I, WI, that is A of I, and M of I with respect, dot M of I with respect to T, into V is equals to, where we can say V equal to V of T M. Okay, this is what the equation for the least squares for the vanishing point where we are writing the formula. Okay, least squares estimates for a vanishing point. Okay, so where M of I we can say is equal to P of I0 into cross, that is P of I1, which we can say is the line segment equation weighted by its length, that is L of I, and W of I, which is equal to P O, that is A of I divide by A of I, which is already there, is the influence of each robustified, that is, we can say, re-weighted measurement of the final error. Okay, so these are the forms are with respect to the vanishing points, we can say, and the things that we need to keep in mind whenever we are talking about the vanishing points. So whenever we are discussing about the vanishing point, and we can say about the curve lines and the line detection points, so we will always be considering the vanishing point with respect to the three of the side that we have already seen, and this we have to keep in mind whenever we talk about for a particular point. Okay, so these are the things with respect to the vanishing points, and we have discussed the line and edge and the curve detection edges or detectors with respect to the properties of it. Okay, thank you.